Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG, and today we're going to be showing you how to update the firmware on your AnyTone handheld radio. Today we're going to be using an 878 UV2 Plus, but it's going to be similar for all of the AnyTone handhelds. Let's get into it. So first thing we're going to do is open up the programming software. So we have it here. I'm going to open that programming software up, the CPS. If you don't have that, we have another video that will show you how to do that. So once you're here, what you'll want to do is actually go to the tool and then firmware and icon update. Go ahead and click on that. Now you'll want to open an update file. If you've downloaded the CPS, it would have actually come with that update file. So just click open update file. And on our desktop here, we recently downloaded the CPS. So we can see that's the file it came with. So if we click on that, we actually get the firmware update as well. So CPS is there, and then here is firmware. So go ahead and click on it. It's going to be an SPI file. You want that, so go ahead and click open. That opens it there. Now what we need to do is actually put our radio into firmware update mode. It's pretty simple to do, but it can be a little confusing. So what you'll do is make sure the radio is turned off. Now hold down the push to talk button, this button right here. Hold that down, as well as the colorful button on top of the radio, and then turn it on, but keep holding those down. There we go. There we go. We can see that red light started to flash up top. That means we are now in firmware update mode. So just go ahead and leave your radio on and take your programming cable. We'll plug that into the computer. And then the other side is going to go into the radio over here. Just like that. Now on the computer, I'm gonna back out of here. What we want to do is go ahead and select the COM port icon right up here in between the read and the write buttons. That will pull up this screen. Just make sure the radio shows up and go ahead and select it. Click OK. That way you won't get any COM port errors. Then we're gonna go back to tool, firmware and icon update. We already have that file loaded in there. So at this time, just go ahead and click write. Write to radio, continue. There we go. So it's going to do that update. Keep in mind, it's always a good idea to back up your code plug before you do this. If you have information on your radio that you don't want to lose, go ahead and back that up. That way there's no chance of you losing anything. So we're just going to wait for this to complete here. Awesome, there we go. So we have completed the update. We can see it booting back up here. So I'm gonna go ahead and unplug it. Should be safe to at this point. And once it's done, if you just wanna verify it worked, you can certainly do that. Go ahead and click on menu, and we'll go down to settings, then go down to device info, and scroll down until you see firmware version. There we go, 2.04. That's what we installed. So we are ready to rock and roll.